Once again, everyone, I'm back. This is Brother Lloyd, and it is a Sabbath. So, also, once again, those who are keeping the Sabbath, I hope you're having a blessed and peaceful day. Now, I'm going to share with you this dream I had, at least the part I remember, because I'm gonna explain to you what I get from it and what it means to me and how I'm going to keep that in my life, because it's important to me, at least. So, I'm asleep, obviously. I haven't been blessed with the ability to go into a transient dream state while I'm awake. So I have to receive dreams while I'm asleep, like most of us do. But I was asleep, and all of a sudden I was dreaming. And I was in a car with a woman. Obviously, I was involved with this woman. And look, one thing, let me tell you about dreams. Sometimes it's not so important as to who or what you're with or around. All those things aren't always relevant, at least at the time. It's important to focus on and understand what's going on with the story of the dream. So, you know, the fact that I'm married and it wasn't my wife, or that I, or if I know it was her, it's not so much relevant as to what happened in the rest of the dream. So anyway, to move on, I was in the dream and we were driving, and we were in some neighborhood, and obviously it wasn't a very good neighborhood, it appeared, by what happened. I'm coming around the one street, and I see farther ahead of me an individual standing there with a gun, and he was shooting it in the air. And as I saw it, and I look, there's a car in front of me, and out of the left side of the car, an individual was leaning out of the car with a gun, and it was starting to shoot back at the individual. And to avoid hitting the car, rearing the car, I swerved to the left, and I drove by the side of the car, and obviously, I guess I startled whoever was in it or what have you. They weren't good guys, obviously, and I saw the car was full of individuals, so I swung and drove by, and then the next thing I know, they're chasing me. So now these individuals are chasing me, and me and the woman in the car, we're driving, and I'm driving, and we're running, flying around this neighborhood trying to avoid them. And I made a turn, they made a turn, and I finally lost them. But now I know they're looking, and so I made a turn down a particular street, and then I made a turn down a street that was straight, but it kind of went downhill a little bit. And I could see on the other side, I saw their car go by in the distance. It's like it looked like a big roundabout type deal. And so I pulled my car down and I stopped, and we got out of the car and we left the car. And so now we're on foot and we left. We're down from in front of the car, and there were these like tall hedges of bushes. So now we're hiding behind them, and there's like a big field. And I want to, you know, it's like my intention is to run across the field to get away and then get lost. But before that could happen, the individuals, I saw them coming down the street or drive where my car had stopped. So they proceeded forwards, presuming that we had come that way. And so now I'm on the other side of the bushes, and the lady that's with me, the girl that's with me, I'm like, come on, let's go. And they're standing there and they're looking around, and they're like five individuals, and they're kind of spread out up there, and they're looking as if they're searching. And I'm like, come on. And so she starts to come, and I turn and start to go, and next thing you know, they're on us, and they're stepping out around us, and I'm like, and I just stop. And so now I'm surrounded. And see, at this point, I don't see the girl or the lady that's with me, because it's not relevant, like I was saying. But it made for whatever's important in the story for me to get to this point. So I'm standing there, and there's some guy in front of me, and he's saying whatever he's saying, and he's referring to me by some name. He's calling me something. And so he's talking, and then next thing I know, Nay has a gun out. And so I just dropped to my knees, and I put my head down, and I put my hands out, And I said this, I said, Father, forgive me for all that I've done against you. And please don't suffer my family the pain of my death. And I just closed my eyes and I had my hand stretched out and the gun went click. And I just took a deep breath and I heard the gun go click again. And then I woke up. And I was like, wow. Now, like I said, I'm not a person who remembers any of my dreams. So do I walk away from this going, wow, that was a weird dream. That was interesting. No, I don't. I hang on to that because there's something in that. There's something vitally important in that, especially for me to remember it in some of the vivid details I remember. So I'm going to hang on to that. And what I do with something like that is I use it. It's knowledge, and it should make me wise and understand some things better. It's going to have me more diligent in maybe where I am or what I'm doing, my wife and I. So I use that and I hang on to it, and I will view that as something from the Father. It's, to me, a warning. This is what I'm saying. To me, it's a warning. It's a warning to be diligent and pay attention to something that obviously hasn't happened, so to some situation or some similar circumstance that may or may not happen to me or someone else. But as I convey it, I remember it. And this is what I'm saying, people. When the Father gives us a message, regardless of what type it is, we have to do with it, or we have to at least hang on to it in the forefront of our mind, because it may be that important. But nothing can compare to being literally told seconds before something is about to happen in a loud, clear, audible voice, as I'm sitting here talking to you and you hear me, when that voice says, do this, not that, and you acknowledge it and then you go against it. Worst case scenario, like I said, it can take you out of your way, or it can delay you, what have you. Pull over. Take a second. Say, wow, okay. Don't go now. Wait. How many of you have been sitting at a red light and your light turns green before and you go, something says, hold up. And all of a sudden you see a car run the light. See, we take stuff like that for granted. But what made you delay? What made you question that? That was a voice. It was an audible voice, because most of us, we like to take off as soon as the light think it's going to turn green. So we have to become more aware of the little things that the Father does for us, the little warnings, the little everything that helps save our lives, that helps continue to give us opportunity to do what is right. So anyway, I just wanted to share that with you, and I will be back in a little while with my last two principles, 5 and 6, in on loving the Father. With that being said, till later, this is Brother Lloyd. I'm out.